It's August, and this is the Library Roadshow. On the show today, poets, musical innovators, and tellers of tales. Welcome to the August edition of the Library Roadshow. I'm Mary Stein, and this is a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. The highlight of the month, we're hosting the 6th annual Mid-City Microcon on the first weekend of August. Authors and inkers will be all over the main library. This year, the lineup includes World Building 101 with Milton Davis, a free drawing workshop with Keith Cartoon Man Douglas, acrobatic performances by the Acadian Circus, a discussion of Nerd Soul with Blurtish, content creation, the Teen Film Festival, and of course, cosplay and so much more. Get all the details at ebrpl.com/mcmc. As part of Symphony Week and to welcome their new director, the Baton Rouge Symphony will be popping up all over town. A string quartet will bring us tunes at noon on Monday, August 7th at the main library. This free concert is sure to be a delight. And later in August, the main library will welcome the St. Albans Ukulele Orchestra for a free concert on Tuesday, August 29th at 6 p.m. And if these musical gatherings inspire you, listen to more on our Medici, Frigel, and Quello concerts platforms in the digital library, or even better, sample music lessons that are available freely on Artist Works. The library's winding up summer reading. You have until August 15th to log all your books, pages, or minutes. And backed by popular demand, Alyssa Trostclair's Get Organized series begins in August. We're hosting a number of local authors in person and national authors online, including standout Saturday Science presenter, Dr. Prasanta Chakrabarty, who will premiere his new book, Explaining Life Through Evolution, and Blake Hicks, whose book, Squeezing Success, was inspired by his daughter's participation in the library's 1,000 Books Before Kindergarten program. Staff will help you reset for back-to-school assignments. We've got the resources you need ready to go. And once you start learning, why stop? Head over to Hive Class and start moving and grooving with hundreds of short micro classes on sports and other activities like yoga and mindfulness. That'll break that summer couch potato malaise and get the whole family ready for the fall. Details are all in the August edition of The Source, available in print and online at ebrpl.com.
Free access to books, audio, and library resources are just a few of the benefits available to you when you get a library card. Need free access to a computer? You get that. Want free access to premium digital resources like Mango Languages and lynda.com? You get that. Need to book a meeting space? You get that. Heck, you can even check out a telescope or use a digital printer with your library card. If you live in East Baton Rouge Parish, pick up your free library card from your local branch library today. Premium access to everything the library system has to offer is waiting for you.
One of the staples in my world through the 20th century was the National Geographic. You know, those stacks of monthly magazines with that iconic school bus yellow cover, filled with incredible photography and stories about people in other lands. There was a companion edition for kids, and I love them both, but really could not keep moving them from house to house. And the library could not keep over 100 years at each location either. So we went to the cloud. It's time to find out more in the digital download.
National Geographic Kids stimulates kids' curiosity through immersive content designed for exploration. This digital resource provides full issues of National Geographic Kids magazine, as well as ebooks, videos, and spectacular images on a kid-friendly platform that makes learning engaging and more accessible. With high-quality informational texts, fun features, and weird and wacky facts, this resource engages students across primary, upper elementary, and middle school grades. National Geographic Kids offers reputable, authoritative, and age-appropriate digital content that brings them the world in a way they have never seen before. It will take them on amazing adventures in science, nature, wildlife, culture, geography, archaeology, and space. The library also offers the National Geographic Virtual Library, which contains over 100 years of the respected publication, available online in stunning detail. You can find both of these resources and much more in the digital library at ebrpl.com.
I grew up flipping through the pages of National Geographic magazines at my house and my grandparents' house, and got the kids' version at school. We saved them all, which meant there was always something to read. So I'm so happy that we make this available digitally for all to access, and without taking up miles of shelving. Teachers and homeschooling parents will want to pay special attention to the special features. And you can complement it with Culturegrams and other fabulous digital platforms. All you need is that library card. Let's shift gears now and go beyond the stack.
His skin was the color of a plum, and even though he was bald-headed, I could tell he was up in years. He looked at me and he said, "I hear you're a storyteller."
Today we're at the main library here at Goodwood, and we are doing a grant screening for Southern Storytellers. Southern Storytellers is a PBS three-part series that premieres next week on LPB.
I think what I want people to recognize about the South is that it is a very, very complex place.
So Southern Storytellers is a three-part series for PBS and LPB, and it looks at unique stories within the southern region of our country. And we have from poets, musicians, artists, and they all tell the story uniquely on film.
From the first time that we can remember somebody cracking open a book, we were probably a child, maybe lying in bed, and they read those magical words, "Once upon a time."
So Spinning Yarn is an extension of what we wanted to amplify out with Southern Storytellers, the national series. So we had to develop a localized version of telling stories uniquely within Louisiana. And so this event today, we identified as Spinning Yarn, an adaptation from a play off the national name. And then we worked to identify three unique individuals who could tell stories today to amplify not only Louisiana unique stories, but also pushing to the national series.
So I started looking around for some place to escape the weather. And lucky for me, there was an old mausoleum that I barely noticed every time I went to the cemetery. But when I got over there, I just made my way over. There was an iron wrought gate there, and I tried to open it. But you know, that thing was old, but at that time of my life, I was young enough to hop right on over it.
Well, one of the most important things that we love is working with the library, because we know that people come here to read, to explore, they're bringing their children. It's a lifelong learning. We at LPB feel very similarly, that we think that we want to provide, both on a broadcast and digital side, lifelong learning. Today, what we hope to do is have three unique speakers talk about their experiences, their life, their work, and get them interested in what's coming up next week on broadcast.
This was truly an outstanding program, and the PBS series is equally exceptional. I strongly encourage you to spend a little time with these Southern Storytellers. The three-part series is available on our local LPB station, as well as through lpb.org. Stay right there. After the break, Patricia Husband joins me for a chat, right here on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that preparing children to enter kindergarten is good for us all. That's why we created Press Start, an early learning initiative that provides a free activity booklet every month that explores early literacy skills through play and interaction at home. Get a library card. Sign up for Press Start at ebrpl.com/kids.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's one in five daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that staying informed is good for us all. That's why we provide free access to the New York Times and other national newspapers online. Permit free access to niche magazines and articles through Press Reader. Get a library card. Get informed at ebrpl.com/newspapers.
You're watching the August edition of the Library Roadshow, everything you need to know about your local library system. Patricia Husband is the library's assistant director of operations, which for many years has included all of our construction and renovation projects. The reason we have so much success with our buildings is partially due to taking the time to listen to what our users are telling us when they come into our libraries, what they like, how they use various features or spaces, and even more importantly, what they feel is missing. We've gotten lots of feedback about services from patrons during the strategic plan survey a few years back, but it's time to focus in on our actual buildings now. So Patricia, tell me about the forthcoming community survey.
Well, the community survey, in a nutshell, is asking patrons to tell us what they like, what they dislike, and how they use the library. And it could be anything that they feel is missing or anything they feel that they really like. So for example, parking, or teen spaces, or study rooms.
They love those.
Or interactive features for children. Anything that they say, this would make my library experience a lot nicer.
That's great. So how are we going to do this?
Well, we have a survey that we're going to be sending out, and it's going to be on the website. It's going to be, there's a link to the website, there are QR codes, it's going to be advertised in the source, and at our library computers and throughout the library.
I may even put somebody in a sandwich board and have them walk around the library.
That's up to you, Mary.
Yeah, it's possible. Who should take this survey?
Anybody who wants to have some input about the community survey and the facilities near them.
And that even means teenagers.
Yes, teenagers can certainly fill out the survey.
They have a lot of thoughts, and teenagers helped design the main library, and it came out pretty well. So we want to hear from everyone. And one thing that I particularly am looking for is non-library users. So why isn't somebody coming to the library? What are we not providing that would bring them to us? And, you know, if they come in, they'll see lots of other stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah. So when somebody sends me a survey, the first thing I think about is, oh goodness, how long is this going to take?
It'll probably take about 10 minutes, maybe a little longer. Most of them are quick answers. There is some place for feedback that you can write in, but it shouldn't take very long at all.
So if you have lots of feedback to fill in those open-ended boxes, you can spend a long time on this, but
yes.
Otherwise you're just going to zip through it.
Pretty much.
I love that. So for just a few minutes to give us the feedback that will change the way we do things in the future is not too bad of an investment of time. We are hoping for thousands of responses. So all those places that you mentioned is a good place to fall into the survey, but the staff, of course, will always help people connect to it. And one thing that we never thought to do before is we're going to make this survey also available in Spanish and Vietnamese, because that's a growing population here in the city. What do we do with the results?
We're going to take the results, compile them, see what things people like, what things people dislike, and find a way to incorporate as many of those features into our renovations and redesigns.
Okay.
For example, at Jones Creek in Greenville Springs, we added study rooms, we added more power and more data.
Oh,
because
yes.
You can never have too much power or data.
That's your favorite. That's right. What other ways can the community participate in basically making the library better?
Well, they can write in. We have comment cards at every branch.
Mm-hmm.
They can email on our website and give us feedback through that. They can email any one of us, and we certainly will take all that information and add it to the mix.
Okay, yes, right, because we're here for the public. Thanks, Patricia. There are so many opportunities to make the library system even better. Now I have two other important administrative announcements. Our Library Board of Control has resumed the search for a new library director, and we hope to complete the process by October. We'll keep you posted. And finally, we are going totally fine-free beginning in August. This starts with book amnesty. So look in your closets, under the bed, behind the sofa, jammed in and under the car seat, and return those long-lost books, magazines, DVDs, CDs, and audiobooks. Return them, no questions asked, and no fines charged. And then going forward, no charges for any late fees. You'll still have to return your items, of course, and we'll still charge you for lost or damaged material, but if your items are a bit late, there won't be any fines. It's all about breaking barriers to access and encouraging engagement. So if you've avoided visiting the library because you had accrued fines in the past, come on back. After the break, author Chad LeBlanc. Plus, we have book reviews from one of our younger library patrons. All that and more coming up next on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that supporting the education of students is good for us all. That's why we provide access to live, in-person, online tutoring through Homework Louisiana. Make available free test preparation tools through Learning Express, plus reference tools for all ages. Get a library card. Get free education at ebrpl.com/homework help.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Welcome back to the August edition of the Library Roadshow. Chad LeBlanc was born and raised in the deep and muddy bayous around Pierrepart, Louisiana. Chad's passion for history drives his belief that everyone should know where they come from. His books center around Louisiana history and culture, and this includes his latest book entitled Roots of the Bayou. Chad joins me now by phone. Chad, how did you actually get your start as an author?
I've always loved history and genealogy, and as I learned more about my own heritage, I wanted to find a way to share that with others.
What is Roots of the Bayou about?
The Roots of the Bayou is a historical fiction novel that tells the story of two families, one Acadian and one Spanish, from the Canary Islands. It explains how each family comes to be in South Louisiana, the difficulties of them starting a new life here, and how they interact with each other.
What do you hope your readers will take away from this book?
The more I've learned about Louisiana history, the more I've realized just how many people are descended from both the Acadians and the Spanish. I wanted to make more people aware of their history, and thought it would be more engaging to do so within the context of a story.
What advice would you share with aspiring authors?
Take advantage of current technology and online platforms. They have made publishing your own writings very easy and feasible for anyone at minimal cost.
How might our viewers learn more about you?
You can learn more about me by visiting my website, www.chadleblanc.com. My contact information is there, as well as information on other books I've written and future projects.
Thanks, Chad. It's now time in our show to check in with one of our younger library patrons and find out what they've been reading at the library.
Hi, my name is Carter. My favorite book is Dr. Seuss. One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. Black fish, blue fish, old fish, new fish. She on has a little star. She on has a little car. My Mimi brings me to the library. I come to the library. I like to play the games at the library and play with the toys at the library. I want to listen in those earphones.
Thanks, Carter. I love to know what kids are reading. And remember, you can still log those books in Beanstack until August 15th to get credit for the summer reading program. Badge up. Stay right there. You're watching the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that making things is good for us all. That's why we have makerspaces at four locations and a 3D printing service at the main library. The makerspaces have a variety of tools and equipment to enable both creative and practical projects. This includes 3D printers, sewing machines, audio-visual gear, and much more. Get a library card. Get free access to makerspaces at ebrpl.com/makerspaces. Access to data is good for us all. That's why we provide free online access to data access reference solutions. Get a library card. Get access to data at ebrpl.com/digital library.
You're watching the August edition of the Library Roadshow, a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. We're always up for a challenge, and we certainly enjoy a good mashup. Let's check in on Orb, gaming through music.
My name is Austin Franklin. I'm a composer, sound designer, technologist, web developer, game developer. This is a solo effort, so it's just me. I had another collaborator help me with some of the graphic design for the game. And I'm here to introduce and premiere a new work of mine. It's a video game controlled by improvising musicians collectively. Any instrument is allowed. And essentially the performers compete for a set time limit, set number of minutes. They collect orbs, power-ups, other kinds of things using the sounds of their instruments, improvising together, so they have to work as a team. And the teams compete for the highest score within the set number, within the set time limit. You're in two teams of three people. We're going to perform for about 10 minutes per team. And you'll see a series of controls, some of which will change throughout the game. There's like obstacles to avoid, things to collect. And then you will use your instrument in collaboration with your other teammates to achieve the highest score possible. This is a computer game. It's called Horde. It's based around bugs, on-screen bugs that you control with your instrument. So anyone who plays an instrument can play into a microphone and control the bugs on screen to collect points, essentially. And your goal is to collect the most number of points within the time limit. I hope to connect people who wouldn't normally play together. So today for the program, we're gonna have a couple of, you know, like teenagers. We're gonna have teenagers playing alongside people who have PhDs in music. And I think that that's incredible. That doesn't happen anywhere else. The other thing is people have a lot of performance anxiety when they perform with instruments. And my hope is that by playing this game, you're sort of alleviated of the anxiety of a traditional performance because you're less focused on the quality of your own sound, but how that sound results in the end goal of, you know, achieving this high score.
Yeah, so this is up to the teams. I don't know how this is gonna work. You'll have to figure that out for me. But you will run into a problem if one of you wants to go up and the other wants to go down at the same time. So there is an element of like competition or collaboration within the groups that your job is to get over, to figure out.
Currently, it is not available publicly. This is the premiere of the game. So the final details, in computer programming, we call them bugs. But the final bugs, the final adjustments, tweaks to the game are being, they were completed earlier this week. So the game is not currently available publicly, but it will be soon.
This was a blend of two of my favorite things, music and technology. And I especially enjoyed the serendipitous aspect of this program. Improvisation keeps you on your toes.
My name is Boo Milton, and we're here at the River Center Branch Library for Write Time. Write Time is a poetry writing workshop for young adults, just to have a safe space to create, explore different thoughts and ideas, and connect with each other. See, when I met you, it was magic. It could have been so tragic. Third grade, same class, the way we met up was classic. What happened? You were snacking, you spilt it and got embarrassed. The other kids started laughing, I looked at mine and let you have it. And ever since we've been friends together through thick and thin, put you on game, you did the same situation, win-win. But now you meeting other men and your boyfriend, he mistreating you, doing things he never did, you letting him influence you. He told you, just like the match, sit back and just relax. He gripping all on your tracks while you sweating and throw it back. But deep inside you feel nothing, just an unfillable hole. Need someone to take the pieces of your heart, use adhesive and make a whole. Cause see, the seconds feel like hours and hours feel like a lifetime. Notice I say hours together, baby, it's not mine. I know I'm intersecting these intersections of love lines. Is this a one-way to your heart, but you're killing me with these stop signs. So when you walk into the right time event, you'll be greeted with a lot of smiles. You'll be greeted with, we got hot tea. We got a lot of different things just to set the atmosphere right. And then once you come in and get settled, we start off with a small introduction just to set the tone for everybody to ground and center. And then after that, we just kind of go over what the agenda is for today, kind of some housekeeping rules, and then we dive into the first prompt. And we're just exploring different topics, and then we have a conversation about it, just to get the ideas and imagination running. And then once we have a conversation, we allow the participants to just write, just take that time, write. We have a DJ, DJ Love Yourself, that plays music very lightly while people are writing. And then after that, we share out. We allow people to just share as much as they want to. We don't force anybody to share. It's just an open space that if you do want to share, you can. And then after that, we repeat that again with a different prompt, and we just keep going until time runs out. One thing about waffles is, if you eat enough of them, you won't turn into one? I don't know. I think that poetry is a real great way for one to explore themselves and to explore the world around them in a real creative way. I feel like imagination is a key element to hope. Imagination is a key element to pushing, you know, our society forward. So if I can create a space to allow people to imagine and then make that imagination tangible in a way, then I want to create the space for it.
Boo is really filling a niche with this program. And now for today's contest. Visit the library's Facebook page at facebook.com/ebrpl. Show me your costume for the MicroCon. That's facebook.com/ebrpl, and while you're there, enjoy. We're not your grandfather's library anymore. What's coming up on the Library Roadshow in September? Our 46th annual Author Illustrator Series presents children's author Carol Boston Weatherford and her son, poet and illustrator Jeffrey Boston Weatherford. It's gonna be special.
Tune in next month, and I'll take you to another library program near you.
Tune into the show next month, and I'll share another free resource from inside the digital library at ebrpl.com.
Thanks so much for joining us on the Library Roadshow. And remember, your East Baton Rouge Parish Library is open 7 days a week at each and every one of 14 branches, plus 24/7 on the web. Check us out at ebrpl.com.